How do you know you exist?
Seeing, hearing, loving, fearing, dreading, dreaming, imagining. Those are all different types of conscious experience. When I see something or hear something, my supposition is, of course, that this is reality, but it's not reality. All we see and all we hear and all we touch, etc., is always mediated through our senses and through our brains. That is very much different in each individual. We live inside this perception box, all of us. And so when something changes in a transformative experience and you expand the walls of your perception box, you interpret it differently from before. So you sort of become more curious. You believe you have agency. You believe you can make a difference in the world. And that is a much more positive attitude, a much more adaptive, beneficial attitude to people, where they're more content and more at ease and more comfortable with themselves and more at home in the world. Hi, I'm Christof Koch. I'm a brain scientist, and I'm both a chief scientist of the Tiny Blue Dot Foundation in Santa Monica, as well as meritorious investigator at the Allen Institute in Seattle. I study consciousness in people and in animals. From a medical point of view, consciousness is defined as awareness of self and others and arousal. What that means, there are basic mechanisms in my brainstem that are absolutely necessary for me to be conscious. They don't provide any of the content of consciousness. You don't love or dream or fear or dread with your brainstem. That really seems to be, in us, the outermost layer of the brain, which is the most excitable piece of active matter in the known universe, the neocortex. Most people are what we call naive realists. They assume that what they see or hear, that's actually what's out there. That is the reality. Now, that may be true for certain things, like, you know, we can all agree. Right now, we're sitting inside a room. Nobody believes that we're in a desert or that we're in virtual reality, right? We're all in a room. There's white paper on the ground, etc., etc. So that's consensual reality. But the fact is, people fundamentally reinterpret things very, very differently. For example, the sense of color. There was a striking phenomenon that went viral, I think 2015, called the dress, hashtag the dress, right? Where there was this picture of a dress that was striped, and half of the people, like including me, saw it unambiguously gold and white. Roughly the other half of humanity insisted that it's blue and black. Now, I believe they're all delusional, but it's a playful example how the same reality can appear very, very different to people. And so we constantly make these unspoken assumptions. It's very difficult to realize, well, this is what I assume about people. This is what I assume about the world. This may not necessarily be true. People in different cultures have sort of explicitly or implicitly devised a whole set of different ways to enable people sort of to be open and curious to the world in the language of perception box, to expand their world. This includes education, first and foremost, understanding that everyone sees the world slightly differently. Not everyone smells and hears and tastes things in the same way. Learning about other cultures, that we all carry biases and they're unconscious, which means you don't know that you're biased. Developing good habits by doing things like reading books, watching movies, talking to other people. Yoga, mindfulness, being in the here and now, these are all traditional, reasonable, well understood ways to sort of enlarge your perception box. We all live in what I call in the gravitational field of planet ego. Just like we always live in the gravitational field of the planet Earth, right? Now there are certain conditions when we can begin, just like an astronaut becomes weightless and floats, when we can lose a self. Literally, we become selfless. When you go into a state of flow, for example, when you are used to be able to do this when I did computer programming, you can totally lose everything around you and you're just fully immersed in your program. When you do meditation under certain types of psychedelics. I had a mystical experience sitting up late on a beach where whatever remained of me became one with the universe. I know it sounds all very woo-woo and crazy, but that's what my experience was. At my age, typically, the way you think about the universe and the metaphysics of what really exists is pretty firmly established. But it was like an earthquake. It really fundamentally shifted the tectonic plates of my understanding. Ultimately, the perception box is instantiated in the brain by the wiring among neurons. That's where sort of the rubber hits the road. And because of your experience, your perception box has changed. resets your mind. You can reinterpret your experiences and look at the same facts in a different light. And if you take that knowledge back into your everyday life, you feel content, you feel in the world. Take the words nowhere. So many of us are nowhere because we're constantly in our phone. So the opposite of mindfulness, we're constantly, okay, he said, now I have to reply to this, I have to like or not like it, whatever. Then you look at the same word nowhere and you pass it differently. Now here. And now you're here. Now you say, okay, now I'm focused. I'm here in my body. Losing ourselves in these artifacts, we all know that's not a good habit. It leads to estrangement from interoception, the ability for us to feel at home inside our body. So it's important to get out there in the world and do things. We want people to be open to the world. We want people to be curious. We want people to understand it's not always about you. It's okay if your ego is out of it. I don't have to have this attitude. I have a choice. I can make difference. And suddenly I can look at the same facts and come to a very different conclusion. When you lose a sense of self, when you see I'm just one among many individuals or many conscious beings, you develop empathy, you develop positive feelings for other creatures that may have different goals than you, that look at the world in different ways, but we're all engaged in the same voyage, bookended between two eternities.